He's described as the big bull or India's best known investor. With us here today on NDTV, Mr. Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, partner of Rare Enterprises. Thank you so much, Mr. Jhunjhunwala, for being with us on
NDTV. Thank you for inviting me.
So plenty of cheer in the festive season for investors.
Well, I think the way India has responded to the downturn, and you know, I don't think with any kind of great stimulus, I don't think there's many stimulus, real stimulus other than the reduction in excise duties. Right. And the reduction in interest rates would have followed. It's no stimulus. It's a consequence of the drop in growth. So I think the way the Indian economy has responded, I think this is optimism not only for this Diwali, but for many Diwalis to come.
All right. So what's your sense of the next few sessions that we're going to see before Diwali? Do you expect that investors will have a good run-up in the pre-Diwali sessions?
Shweta, it's very difficult to predict day-to-day movements. You know, you can predict the direction, you can't predict the depth and the day-to-day movements. But my personal feeling is that the way market has been going up with a tremendous breadth, reasonably good volumes, and a lack of participation, I don't think markets can peak easily. I think there has to be, you know, every stock goes up, corrects, goes up, corrects.
Right.
You know, you look at Hindalco, so many other stocks. So I don't think that any kind of a peak can be made unless there is a burst of rise. A rise in which there's a complete, you know, markets, see, the stocks will rise 30% in three weeks. And then I think unless the mass participates, I don't think the markets can peak. So I can say the direction, both short-term and long-term, is upward. But what will happen in the next few sessions, I think, is difficult to predict. It depends a lot on what kind of results we get.
We're in the middle of the results season and we've seen better than expected results from some major blue chip companies. Do you expect this trend to really continue and have some sort of an impact on the markets?
See, what I think is analysts have figured out a lot of things. But I think the way corporate India is restructured and cost cut, I personally think results could and would surprise on the upside. Right? And maybe not so much, you know, not by a very large percentage, but surely then would come a trend whereby people would, you know, improve forecasted earnings for the future.
Right. We've already seen some upgrades on earnings that are coming in, but the important factor here for investors to note is the kind of impact that results and earnings will now have on markets. Earlier we used to see that earnings used to be this major mega event for the stock markets. Do you think slowly the results season is losing its relevance out in determining the direction of the stock markets?
Not at all. I think, you know, when you are at a turning point as we are, when we are coming in from a downturn into an upturn, see, the results is a confirmation of what people's prognosis.
Right.
And also it's an indication of what's going to happen in the future. So I think this time result season is extremely important, both for the September quarter, December quarter and the March quarter.
You mentioned that there is definitely an upward trend in the stock markets, both in the short term and the long term. But a lot of pessimists will also say that this market is now getting overheated, valuations are getting overstretched.
I don't think valuation is overstretched, in my personal opinion. Valuation is a matter of opinion and a matter of perception. I don't look at valuation. I look at it in absolute terms beyond a point. But I don't think we've reached that point. Right? And I look at valuations in terms of participation, in terms of beliefs, expectations.
Tubar.com.